Friends, this is Summer Days DIYs. Our host is Six Kids and a Glue Gun and Lady in Red Crafting. The guest host is East Coast Mama. Please check out their channel in the description box. And please check out the playlist of all the other amazing creators to find fun summer DIYs. Today, Terry will be painting a ladybug on a flower. If you haven't subscribed, it's free. What are you waiting for?
Okay, we're going to paint this cute little ladybug on a flower. So first off, we're going to do our background. I got out some pastel colors, pink, blue, green, yellow. Any of those colors will work. So we want it to have kind of a springy going into summer look here. Actually, I want to add, my yellow's a little bit too yellow. I'm going to add some white just in case we need more. So first off, I want more green down here in the corner because this will be the lower part. And wipe that off on my paper towel. I don't need to clean my brush. And I'm going to come in here with some blue. Now I'm on canvas, so my paint needs to be a little bit more damp than if I'm painting on wood. And I'm just going to slap that right through from one side to the other. I don't want to dirty it. And I don't want to get, more too much color in there. Okay, then I'm going to pick up. I am going to clean my brush because I'm going to go into the yellow. I'm going to put a little bit of white in with my yellow since it's so bright. Water. So this is a canvas board, not just a canvas, so it does require more water. All right, then I'm going to wipe that off and pick up my pink and start on this corner. Okay, then I can pull that into my yellow and we create a really pretty background. Then I'm just going to take that brush, kind of clean some of that pink off here and there. Now again, this is just our background, so you're not going to see a whole lot of this by the time we get our image put in there. But there, that makes a nice springy background. I'm going to add a little bit of white. Just get up in here a little bit. So this will always look different. You can do it with different colors, but that's the color background that I want to get started. So I'm going to draw out my pattern and then we'll pick up. Okay, so I sketched in a ladybug and a flower. Now I'm going to grab a filbert brush. Quite a big one because we had a lot of space to fill in here. So I added in some bright pink along with the lighter color. And I'm gonna put my brush on both sides. And then I'm gonna pick up a corner of each and then blend that out. Let's see what we've got here. So I'm gonna start down here at the bottom. Pull it down one side and then the other side. We may have to come back in, it looks like, and shade and highlight. I thought I was going to be able to get them in one stroke, but apparently not. So let's just fill this in. And it doesn't matter what colors you use because we will be shading and highlighting. Can look really pretty against this background, nice and springy. Then let's add yellow, the same yellow that we used at the background, since I have that on my palette, and we'll put that in the center of the flower. Then we need red for our ladybug. Got a shell up here. Again, you're working on canvas, so you'll need a little bit more water than what I usually use for wood. Then black on the head. Okay, now I'm going to take a break. I am going to go over my, let this dry. Then I'm going to give all my colors one more base coat. And then we're going to add in all the fun stuff, all the fun details. After this. All right, I thought that his face would look a little bit better if I added, this is just a very light beige onto his face right there. While I'm there, I'm going to keep that paint on my brush, pick up just a little bit of this honey brown, which is a very light brown. And I'm gonna go in there and shade that up. I'm gonna shade underneath where his nose is going to be while I have this in here. And I'm gonna shade down along the bottom of his face. There we go. Now on the flower, the petal part, let's add in some shading of orange. I'm going to use this Warm Sunset because it's the first one that I picked up. And I'm again going to just touch the corner. And we're just going to go right along the edge. And then right up underneath our ladybug. We're gonna let that set for right now. I wanna shade on the red part of his shell with just a little bit of black on the edge of my brush. Now let's go down to where we started with those petals. I'm gonna take that big filbert brush again. And I picked up some purple. It is, find which one it is. But this is Violet from Anita's Paint. I think it'll look pretty incorporating that. So again, I've got it on the corner of my brush, and I'm just going to come down from the center and pull up. Again, down here, turn around and pull it up. So you're gonna do that on each of these petals. Ooh, I like that color. The color turned out really pretty, combining those two. We got this little one right over here. So I'm shading on both sides of that petal, giving it more color. That looks good. In fact, I'm gonna go over my orange with that. I'm gonna enhance the color of the center as well. Perfect. Now we want a scruffy brush. You want one that, that one doesn't work at all. Let's find one that we can really scrub with. Okay, so this used to be a nice liner brush. I'm gonna dip it in my white, actually. And I'm going to take most of it off. And then scrub right in the center, getting right up to that edge. And you can see where my purple wasn't, you know, was kind of not uniform. You can just scrape right over the top of that, and it's going to change the look of your petal. Grab some more white here. More, scrub it off. Add some more. Ooh. Got a lot there. That's all right. I'm gonna pull some over on the other side and stay to the top because that's where our sun's coming down more over here. I'm just going to disperse more on the other ones, get that used up. There, I like that. Now let's try to get in. Staying away from the shading on the center. Make sure I am going to clean my brush just in case I got pink on it, because I want to come in and add white to the top of my ladybug as well. So it's pretty dry. I want to add just a little touch of yellow to that as well. Let me make sure I take, really scrub that off. We want our brush really dry here. And we're gonna stay on the top. scratch that in. Oh, I love how that turned out. And go ahead and go right here on the face as well. I know it doesn't have much yellow in it at all, so. And then try to get just a little bit on the black portion as well. It kind of brings them to life right there. Now on our dots, just take the end of an old brush. Oh, actually, sorry. I'm going to take my flat brush, pick up some more white on the edge. We're just going to enhance that highlight right here on the top. There we go. While I've got it, I'm gonna go on top of the head a little bit too. Perfect. So add a little bit more in the face. Okay, we're just going to dip the end of our brush in black, and we're just going to put random dots. Now the thing with these dots is they get really thick, and you're going to want to let them dry for a couple of hours. It takes a while. I like to leave them overnight if I wanted to go in and add any more detail. Right now I'm good with it the way it is, I hope. But usually for me, and this is one place where I like to do this at the end usually, because I'll stick my hand in it somewhere. Make sure you have some that go off. And if you want to do that a little bit easier, let me grab some more black. I'm doing that. So say I want this one to go off the page. I'm going to put my scrap paper there. Oh, well, that didn't work too well, did it? So now I'll have to go in and fix that. Maybe I will have to do that with the actual bristles of the brush and not the end. So let me show you how to clean that up. Hopefully we can get to it. Just take a clean wet brush. Go in there, pick that up, and then wipe it on your paper towel. Make sure your water's clean. There we go. We're going to shade around that too, so. Now let's try that the right way. I thought I'd get by with it, but apparently not. I'm going to put that right there. There we go. And you can also just make your dots using your brush. Smaller one up here. Okay. Now down on the petals, I'm going to take a liner brush and we're going to add in some stripes there. So I'm going to use the dark purple that I shaded with right here. Roll that brush in there. Just touch and pull. You can add as many as you would like. You don't want your lines to be solid either. Just let them flow right there. And I always go around the outer edge of each petal as well. I have to go back and get the other ones. Now to add a little variation, I mean, clean that brush and go in with just the white. Sorry, my phone quit videoing. So I went in and added some white lines to my petals as well. I'm going to grab a little bit of white. Go ahead and start getting my eyes ready here. Just a little U shape there at the bottom. While we've got this, let's go ahead and add in some of our highlight lines. And put just a little wide U shape in each of these dots. And then a little drop of white in each eye. Cute. Now I want to use that liner brush, get it very fine, whatever liner brush you like to use, and I just want to put a small mouth in here. Perfect. You want that as fine as you can get it, and then I'm going to add in just couple of eyebrows, and then I'm going to go under that nose. I need to go back and highlight that as well here in a moment. We're just going to put a couple detail lines around the face. And then using the black, I'm going to outline the center of our flower. You don't have to, but I do like to outline even my petals. I just think it gives it more of a complete look. There we go. Now we have to put, oops, before we put legs in it, we need to do something with the center. And I'm gonna take a small flat brush. And I'm just gonna do, actually we'll take that same purple. And let's put some hash marks in here, some stripes. And then go across those stripes and make a checkered look for it. That looks good. Then I can also, let's take a little bit of white because we can, and just put in some little white dots. That'll set it off even more, and that's something nice and simple that you can add. Perfect. Now we need some legs. So taking a liner brush. So we've got a small leg coming out here because he's crawling. And one right here in front. Oops, got into my white dot. So that'll have to have another coat of black when we're done. We'll have some little feet showing up here. I don't know how many legs a ladybug has. Try to stay away from that big dot. Then put more of a black line right there under his face. And I'm pretty happy with the way he turned out. A little bit of white across the top of his nose. And that little guy is just darling. And touch down a little bit of red. Just then add a little bit to his face right there in his cheek area. There we go. Now when you're done with this, seal it with a clear outdoor spray is what I like to use, or the sealer of your choice. But he looks totally adorable. If you wanted, you could even go underneath those petals with a darker green. I think I do want to see how that'll look. Kind of lift it off that background. If I have a dark green. Here we go. This Hauser dark green will work. So taking a flat brush, oh yeah, I like that. It really separates that off. You can pull some of that down if you'd like. And there we go. We have a very cute little ladybug. All right, thank you for joining me. Okay, once I finished the ladybug, I remembered that I hadn't put his antennas in there yet. So you'll just use your liner brush, bring them up, curve them over, add a little dot at the end of there. And then I still have to go in and add a little bit of white to his feet. But otherwise, he turned out really cute. It's a great project, nice and easy.